everyone. Welcome back to the Rasa Masterclass. We have reached the finish line of the series. So with this episode, I would like to recap on what we have learned and say a huge thank you for following the Masterclass. With the latest episode of the Rasa Masterclass, we finished covering the most important building blocks of developing AI assistants with Rasa tools. In episode 1, we discussed what does it mean for an assistant to be contextual and how Rasa enables you to build such assistants. Then, we started working on an actual assistant, a Medicare locator assistant. We started with designing the most important conversations and creating some NLU training data, as covered in episode 2. In episodes 3 and 4, we dived into the training of NLU models, covering the pre-configured training pipelines, as well as building custom training pipelines using different components. In the later episodes, we dived into the dialogue management, from designing some training stories in episode 5, understanding the components like domain, slots, and how were they used to model the dialogue turns in episode 6, all the way to diving deep into the dialogue management training policies in episode 7. From then on, we focused much more on the actual development of our assistant, adding custom actions with backend integrations, implementing forms in episode 8, then deploying RasaX on a server using Docker Compose in episode 9, and from then on using RasaX to iterate on our assistant until it became good enough to be shared with real testers in episode 10. In episode 11, we covered an extremely important next step, sharing your assistant with real users. More specifically, how you can connect your Rasa assistant to external channels like Telegram or your own website. And last but not least, we covered how you can deploy RasaX on a scalable Kubernetes cluster in episode number 12. These 12 episodes were intended to show you how the process of developing an AI assistant with Rasa tools looks like, from the very beginning, where you only have just an idea for your assistant, all the way to the final step, deploying your assistant in production and iterating on it based on what you learn from the conversations real users have with your assistant. I really hope that Rasa Masterclass inspired you to build conversational AI assistants that go beyond simple FAQ interactions, and that it helped you understand the main building blocks of the development. This is the end for the Rasa Masterclass series, but it's just the beginning for our effort to help you build great contextual AI assistants. What topics would you like us to cover in the future? Let us know about it in the comments below, and we will make sure to include them in our next developer education projects. Thank you so much for hanging out with me throughout the series. I learned a lot, and I hope that you did too. I'll see you in the future videos, blog posts, and live events. So keep on building, keep on learning, and I'll finish with my usual, until next time.